I love democracy. I love the Republic.
The main thing is to protect these characters, make sure that they still continue to live in the way that you created them, and that the universe of Star Wars continues to grow.
So guys, this is part one of a sort of two-part video. I didn't want to do everything in one because it's going to be very hard for everybody to understand what's going on all at once. So yesterday I talked about Star Wars Celebration not streaming and the report from the Star Wars .com itself that Celebration was canceled for next year. And now we know the reason. There's a big reason why. Okay. And I don't want to get in too much of that. Suffice it to say, Star Wars Celebration will not be this year what you think it's going to be. And a lot of the Fanboy Incorporated will take everything that is going on and think that it's the opposite of what it is, okay? And I don't want to exactly explain what that is right here because I want to put context to everything. We know for a fact that Lucasfilm, along with the rest of the Disney brand, is going through major upheaval. People are getting laid off and they're going through restructuring. And it looks to me that what's going on, at least just from what we can see, and this is about what we know in the news, is that there's going to be major changes coming to Lucasfilm, and they're going to be definite. And the fans are going to see it. They're going to feel it. One of those is what is going to be happening at this year's current celebration. We know that they're not streaming it, and there's a big reason why. And I will put context about why they're not streaming it. And there isn't going to be a celebration next year. Now, the excuse is money, but I have an idea that they're going through basically a content change, a leadership change. But let's talk a little bit about the other part of the context, okay?
Well, Your Highness, guess this is it.
That's right.
Don't get all mushy on me. So long, Princess.
Now, literally 2 years ago, Kathleen Kennedy did the Science Tech Awards on the Oscars channel, and as you can see, she got ratioed into oblivion. 10,000 dislikes. And the comments were up to almost, I think they're like 5,000 hate comments. And the next time she did a video where she was interviewing somebody, she got ratioed again. So the Oscars turned off the comments, turned off the likes, and basically left it at that. This is a big lesson to learn now. I want you to understand why the Star Wars channel will not be streaming anything, okay? But let's go into why all that happened 2 years ago, because this was very significant. This is very significant. 2 years ago, Gina Carano was told by Deadline and not by Kennedy herself that she wasn't going to be re-upped for her renewed for her contract in for Mandalorian. So this kind of put a dent in what Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni were trying to do with Rangers of the New Republic. She was going to be the leader. We all know that Kathleen Kennedy hated her. I couldn't stand her. I would think that Kennedy would admire a woman who was independent, who spoke her mind, but apparently you couldn't speak your mind if you didn't agree with Kathy and Pablo Hidalgo and everybody else. There was a story that Hidalgo cocked off to Gina about her sister getting COVID, and Gina ripped him a new asshole, and Pablo went crying to Aunt Kathy. So there's a lot of bad blood, and this is what caused, really did cause, because what I think, I don't know, I think Kennedy probably would have been ratioed not as much had this not happened, but it was like, it's not that Cara Dune was that important to Star Wars. She's not Princess Leia. She's not Luke Skywalker. She's not Han. She's not Padme Amidala. She's not Anakin. She's not Obi-Wan Kenobi. But the fans rallied around her because she was basically saying a lot of the stuff that they thought, that they felt about the world. And when she was kicked off the team, that was personal for people. So they took it and ran with it. And I've got to say, in the world of me, I never expected to see 10,000 dislikes to, like, I think there were only 100 likes. And the constant barrage of F you, bitch, Kathy, blah, blah, blah. Lots of Gina Carano quotes floating around. And this one was the big one that was all sprinkled all through the comments, I remember. And I actually thought I took screenshots. I'm going to have to look. Maybe I did, and I just haven't found them yet. But it was very interesting. This was February 21st, 22nd, 2021. So a lot of this stuff, I mean, she meant a lot and to people, and people were pissed off. And it's interesting, this whole journey that we've gone through with her, and I don't care if she comes back or not, but the fact of the matter is, it might be good business sense if they did bring her back. And Deadline Hollywood talked to, Jon Favreau, Dave Filoni, and basically they didn't say she was coming back. In fact, Deadline said no, because look, they don't want her to come back. Okay, look, that's their take. The fact of the matter is, the boys are openly talking about Gina Carano, and the press in Hollywood has actually been more lenient on her than they were. Okay, everybody saw the meme she posted. It had nothing to do with being anti-Semitic. What it was a picture of a group of Jewish people being rounded up, maybe in Poland, France, Italy, Hungary, Greece, we don't know, and by the Nazis. But the meme was, it could happen anywhere to anybody, which is true. Genocides have happened for thousands of years all over the human race. I mean, we've got the Armenian genocide, which was the biggest, first one of the 20th century. Pol Pot, Joseph Stalin killing millions of Ukrainians. And of course, we can't forget Chairman Mao killing maybe upwards of 100 million people, his own people, during his culture war. His great leap forward, which was kill everybody who doesn't agree with me. Okay, fine. And right now the Chinese communists are doing that to the people in their Western provinces, the Muslim minority called the Uyghurs. Okay. They're in camps. Disney actually made a movie next to their camps and then thanked the division of Chi Com Central for allowing them to shoot there. That's pretty gross. Really, that's gross. So the meme wasn't anti-Semitic, but considering The kinds of people who run Hollywood, not very bright, not very intellectual. She got utzed for it. And Kennedy used it to say no more. Now it looks like there may be a light at the end of the tunnel on that. Now, this is the context for the next video. So enjoy it. Get ready, because in about a couple hours, I will drop the next one. This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.